Oh, what on earth?
Senator Hanson.
I'm quite happy to remove this because this is not what should belong in this parliament.
A unified, one-party government will be able to finally win a war against the emus. We need to make up for our loss against them in 1932, somehow.
I mean, you know, people are entitled to their sexual proclivities. You know, I mean, let there be a thousand blossoms, blooms, fucked up, and so, you know, but I ain't spending any time on it, because in the meantime, every 3 months, a person was torn to pieces by a crocodile in North Queensland.
With really dumb statements like this coming from politicians like Queensland's Bob Katter, I think Australia would benefit much from a communist government where ruthlessness and single-party dictatorship gets you power, and not stupidity. Such a people-led government will understand how weird it is to name a pool after Prime Minister who went for a swim and simply disappeared. That was Prime Minister Harold Holt. The fact that most of you don't know this really speaks to how exceptional our government is at barely doing anything. Now they'll go further. They'll name the Navy after him, out of a need for a mythical leader out of which to create a cult of personality. This way, we'd be naming the entire Navy after the most visible part of anything that we have to do with our oceans. After all, we are about to lose the Great Barrier Reef, the largest organism on the planet, thanks to our well-despised fossil fuel industry. It's as intelligent as naming our Air Force Icarus. With employers able to access our internet history, and police legally permitted to violently suppress any demonstrations that they want, a communist government will finally give them something to defend, an excuse for this kind of beta authoritarianism. Using exorbitant military spending, like communist Albania's 30% yearly budget on defense, we can finally wage a two-front war, both against the penguins. Well, why else do we have millions of World War II era artillery bases in Melbourne, half a planet away from Japan? And we can finally obliterate pathetic Tasmania out of the map so that it finally won't exist anymore. Australians are known for some pretty exceptional things. Trying to sell New Zealand on the online market eBay for one. Well, a communist Australia will be able to sell out our entire nation while still looking honourable. We stay a fossil fuel reliant nation, and now we can also be a third world economy, just like the USSR. Australia can finally embrace the fact that it is leagues behind New Zealand in nature conservation, amongst most other things, and declare war on nature, just like the USSR. I'm sure the people in the fossil fuel blooded liberal government will be ecstatic. I'm pretty sure they'd want to declare war on nature, but they don't need to. They are at war either way. It is the natural continuation of our incredibly left-wing and progressive history. On day one, 1901, women had voting rights, whilst American women basically had to wait a generation after that.
A large majority of Australians wished to see the banning of the burqa.
White Lives Matter, burqa ban, Queensland politician Pauline Hanson can finally gain national power by agitating the public into a fear of being surrounded by improving capitalist economies that happen to be majority Muslim, that may soon overshadow our own corrupt corporatocracy. With our government building coal mines for Adani and other companies before they even ask for them, this is only natural. Okay, maybe it's Queensland and not Tasmania that we should obliterate. If you don't understand the honourable cause I'm promoting, rest assured. As communist leader Joseph Stalin probably said, humour is like food. Not everyone gets it. Like, or else we will send you to the gulags. And subscribe to our Red Army. Did we miss any crucial reasons why Australia should be communist? Have a suggestion for what country we should make communist next? Comment down below. Thanks for watching.